open a new document. I am choosing 1000 by 1000. Send at the document by pressing Ctrl 0. Make sure you have no fill and only stroke selected. Press L on your keyboard to select the ellipse tool and make a circle 200 by 200. This will depend on the size of your artboard or the size of the design you want to create. Press Shift and Alt on your keyboard and make a copy till it snaps to the outer circumference of the first circle. Press R on your keyboard and Alt press at the center of the first circle. Give 20 degrees and hit copy. Now press Ctrl D to duplicate it till you have the completed form. Now press M on your keyboard to get the rectangular tool and select 400 pixels, center it. This should enclose the design perfectly. Having the square selected, hit rotate and rotate it by 20 degrees till you get the design. Press Alt R or press L on your keyboard to go for the ellipse tool and choose 565, or you need to have a circle which will actually touch the outer edges of the squares drawn. Go to the select tool and hit Ctrl Y to get into outline mode, and to make micro adjustments press Ctrl on your keyboard and move the scroll wheel. For me 0.5 works fine. This will differ on the size of your document. Now draw another rectangle, in this case it's a square, which will enclose the circle. So again it needs to be perfectly touching the circle, so 565 will work for me, and center it properly and do check if it is touching the circle perfectly. Hit Ctrl 0 to zoom out. With the square selected, select rotate tool and go for 20 degrees and hit copy. Then hit Ctrl D to duplicate it. This has to be enclosed by another circle. I'm putting 800, center it, but when I zoom in you will see it's not perfectly done. So I go to outline mode and you will see it's not perfect. So try to be as precise as possible. Again hold the Ctrl key and use the scroll wheel to do it, and for me a 0.5, a 0.6 will do it. Hit Ctrl 0 to go out and again press Ctrl Y to leave outline mode. Now that's your design. Now we have to color it. Choose two different colors. It can be any different color. So you can use the recolor artwork option later. But if you want to just make it black and white, you can use the black and white and that will do for you. I'm using black for now for the starting color. The effect will depend on the where you place your colors. For mine I'm choosing this. If you make a mistake, hit Ctrl Z and go back and redo it. I just speed up the whole process. Remember, you make a mistake, you hit Ctrl Z, go back and redo it. Zoom in so that the boxes you are coloring are precise. Make a mistake, go back. or you have to do it the other way around, where you have to choose the different color or the other color you are wanting to use and select that and make the, correct your mistakes. The more precise you are, the better your design will be. Similarly, following the pattern above, you are going to color the pattern in the second pattern. So I am choosing the diamond shapes. Try to be as precise as possible. Zoom in so that you can fill the required boxes or the required diamonds and triangles with proper color. Similarly, do the same thing for the circular design. This design has only circles and squares. Now, after you finish with the innermost design, you have to choose a different color. I'm choosing a lighter gray color and fill in all the white parts. Again, you make a mistake, you just need to hit Ctrl Z, or you have to choose black as the other color, because I have black as the other color, and fill in the design. You have to be as precise as possible. Now, let's make a background for it. Select the square tool or the rectangular tool and make a rectangle which is bigger than the design. Give it a color. In my case, I'm using an even lighter shade of gray. Right click on the rectangle and send it backwards. Go to arrange and send it back. That's your basic design. Now we are going to use the recolor artwork option.